Fans, welcome to the Jack Simpson Gym at the University of Calgary for the Calgary Senior High School Athletic Association's Senior Boy Division I Championship game between the Sir Winston Churchill Bulldogs and the Bishop McNally Timberwolves. And now, here is tonight's starting lineup for the Timberwolves. At guard, number 3, Redmond Quiambo. At guard, number 4, Terrence Chrysostomo. At forward, number 11, Ivan Ekome. At forward, number 12, Clayton Henry. And at post, number 22, Jairus DeJesus. Coaches for the Timberwolves are Tyler Coral and James Wood. Your officials this evening are Donald McDonald, C. Artis Jr., and Mike Batante. Fans, would you now...
And the Division I Championship is underway. The tip won by Sir Winston Churchill and now taken back by the Timberwolves. Redmond Quiambo, Terrence Chrysostomo, Ivan Ekome, Clayton Henry, and Jairus DeJesus, the starting five. Ekome mishandles the ball, nearly goes out of bounds. Bad opening shot that time for Quiambo, and it's taken down by Sir Winston Churchill. Ogawa, Darian Valdez kicks out and a traveling violation. And there is the roar from the crowd. So Winston Churchill, Matt Fullerton, Nico Ogawa, Darian Valdez, Vlad Zasmolin, and Cobin Jopp. So early on, a couple of rough plays to start off. Maybe the kids just trying to get going. Obviously, some early jitters with this huge crowd.
Yeah, when you're playing in front of 3,000 people, as we get a travel in the other direction, it can be tough. It can be intimidating. That's why the warm-up is more important today than it would have been in any other game they would have played all year. You just get used to the environment, how everything's going to work, how the ball bounces off the rim, and then you're ready to go.
Nice look for Jopp from Matt Fullerton, the coach's son, with the early assist to the big man Jopp. These two teams played in the regular season, and it was Sir Winston Churchill defeating Bishop McNally 82-69. Chrysostomo, beautiful move right to the rack.
This crowd is going to have a who can be louder contest later tonight. Manny Bular is the MLA for the McNally region, so
we know where his preference is.
Yeah.
As we see Ekome, the catch, the shoot, and the miss right into the hands. A job once again beating Bishop McNally at the floor, but a traveling violation.
It's a game like this that sometimes the first minute can be as exciting as the last minute, simply because can the game live up to the hype? Because this crowd, like, I can only see a couple of dozen maybe empty seats, and let's just say the neutral fans are on the near side of your screen, and the team fans are on the far side.
Behind their benches, of course. Here's Chrysostomo, goes to the crossover, goes at Jopp, he'll pull up, shuffled his feet a little bit, and another traveling violation. So once again, perhaps those jitters becoming an issue. Two Calgary programs, go ahead.
Exactly, and you just slide just that extra centimeter. I know all three of these referees, and they don't care who wins. They're just gonna call everything down the middle, and they're the best three that you could have asked for this game.
Cheers of defense from the crowd. Here's Valdez, the catch and shoot, the long three. That's off, and skying for the rebound is Clayton Henry, one of the co-captains of this team, along with Ekome. Henry will take the jumper, misses. So a slow offensive start for these two teams. Here's Fullerton with some speed. Fine job inside, beautiful dish once again. It's Fullerton to Jopp, and it's 4-2 lead for the Bulldogs. Chrysostomo gets into the paint once again, the little floater, and hits it. So all 4 points for each team coming from one player, Chrysostomo and Jopp. Fullerton takes the screen, met by DeJesus. Fullerton tries to go to the crossover, but here's the steal. Clayton Henry goes behind his back with the left hand. Beautiful move. Oh, Henry.
And even some fans in that neutral area got on their feet for that one.
Valdez will take another deep three, misses, so 0 for 2 start for Valdez. That time, Zaz Mullen looking for Jop inside, intercepted. This first quarter going right by Gricostomo. The long three-point attempt, a big one for Priambo. And it's 9-4, an early lead for Bishop McNally.
We're playing with the red three-point line, not the black. That's for the Dinosaurs.
Ogawa, Zaz Mullen, goes baseline, met by DeJesus. It's Jop, a wide open look, and can't finish. Big rebound for Vladdy. And here's Fullerton. Ogawa, and draws the foul. He'll go to the line. And that's the first foul of the game. It'll go against Gricostomo. Gricostomo, Nakomi, and Henry, the three key players for McNally. Speaking with head coach Mike Fullerton of Sir Winston Churchill, he said, you know what, we're a deep team. If somebody isn't getting it done, someone else will step up. And we'll see what happens, especially with eight seniors for Sir Winston Churchill and seven for the T-Wolves.
And that's the key. LeBron can't win the game by himself, and neither can these guys. Neither can their superstars. So it's a full team effort and a full bench effort as well. These 11s are going to make just as big of a difference, even if right now they don't think they will.
Big rebound inside, and a strong move by Jamin Pelly, and a whistle will go the other way. We'll say like LeBron can't win a game by himself. Don't tell the Detroit Pistons that from that conference finals.
Or
anyone he's destroyed, exactly.
Yeah. 1-on-5 just doesn't work, even if it is him.
9-6, the points. Fullerton, beautiful dish.
Oh, well done.
The job once again. And right now it's Fullerton and Jop connecting. Three assists for Fullerton, all going to the big man, Cobbin.
You track more than one person to stare at the ball, and that's the payoff you can get.
Clayton Henry goes inside. Gricostomo back out. Priambo, who hit that three. A couple possessions to go. We'll try to hit another. That one's off, and a rebound for Ogawa. Here comes Sir Winston Churchill on the break. Once again looking for Jop, intercepted by Ikomi. After the Wolves took a five-point lead, it's only one now. Amazing atmosphere here at the Jack for the city title. And doing his best to get it is Ikomi. His first bucket of the game. Sir Winston Churchill only losing to St. Francis in the regular season, 89-77. Valdez, he's looking for his first points, and he gets them. And he's got the hair to go with it. It's a thing of beauty.
Jerry Valdez.
That is beautiful. I mean, that's just beyond gorgeous.
Well, we've seen in the previous two games, along with this one, three games worth of interesting hairstyles, let's just say that.
Nice jumper from Henry. He has 4 points, and it's 14-10 T-Wolves. Fullerton takes the screen, gets in, looking for Jop again, but intercepted. Crumbo, pass for Costomo up ahead, gets to the ball, goes up at the right, and scores.
Good look there, but Fullerton looking like Steve Nash, always looking for the pass. And Quiambo was able to anticipate that, creating the turnover and the bucket at the other end.
Valdez with some open space. Beautiful dish. Go! The two-handed rim racker. And gets it. The Churchill fans all jacked up.
And a great pass by Valdez. Just a fantastic pass.
If there's one area where Sir Winston Churchill definitely has an advantage, it is size. More muscle for Churchill, more height. So that'll have to be offset by the Bishop McNally guards and their speed. Coming into the game now, Wesley Cole for Sir Winston Churchill, as well as Amri Gill. We'll take a break. Bishop McNally is certainly just a much shorter team, so they're going to try to get onto the open floor, create turnovers like they did on that last layup by Gricostomo. Henry goes to the spin. Guess by Vlad with the reverse. What a beautiful move from the senior captain. And he looks to the crowd saying, this is my floor. Amory Gill is able to get a couple of players in the air. Vlad Zasimov, the pump fake works. He drives in, doesn't get the call, and a big rebound for Henry.
Good pump, good bump there by Jamin Pelly, number 33. He's kind of playing like the middle linebacker he appears to be, and that little bump made sure that the basket did not go in.
Henry misses the jumper. And a rebound by Gill. Three Gills on this team, they are not related. Drive by Cole, and we're gonna get a traveling violation first. Wesley Cole, the younger brother of former Calgary Dino Alex Cole.
In for the Bulldogs, number 10, Terry Calhoun.
And now, Zaz Mullen will check out of the game.
Tells you something when the coach is the shortest guy on the bench.
That shot by Jamin Pelly is off. Damian Valdez tried to run, but it's a steal. Here come the Timberwolves. Into the game, Braden Baltazar. Cricostomo gets right by Cole, goes up, and can't finish at the rim. But there's Jamin Pelly for the offensive putback. And now the Wolves have extended their lead 20-12.
Those cases, it's nice to have a teammate backing you up, but you got to go the overhand off the square instead of the underhand little scoop shot to get it just past the rim.
Cole tries to get by Pelly, draws the foul, and it'll be two shots for Wesley Cole, one of the eight seniors on this team, along with Jesse Tam, James Jacob, Sam Kerber, Nico Ogawa, Wesley Cole, Darian Valdez, Emery Gill, and Cigar Graywall. There's a look at the replay. That shot obviously not counting, and there is Cole. The southpaw hits the free throw. And a correction of mine, the bucket did count. Excuse me. Good break for Bishop McNally. The ball goes right into the hands of Clayton Henry. Henry, rather, and the putback is good. He has 8 points to lead his team. Amory Gill, dangerous pass, goes to Fullerton. Fullerton,
oh wow,
was looking for Chop, but it gets tangled up. Here comes Cricostomo, using his blazing speed and scores at the rack. Cricostomo now with 8 points, showing that phenomenal ball handling ability. And the T-Wolves breaking out to a 24-15 lead with a minute 15 remaining in the first quarter.
Fullerton looking a little frustrated, not being able to execute every single play that he wants, but Churchill's still well into it.
And Cole, sorry, go ahead, Dave.
And if you can keep drawing fouls on Jamin Pelly, that might be a good strategy. Two fouls for him in 9 minutes, and he's looking a little verklempt here, not really sure how and why that happened.
Well, we'll get another look at it as Wesley Cole draws another foul and returns to the free throw line. Hits the first. 4 points now for Cole off the bench. He and Valdez, that phenomenal pair, and hits both. So 3 for 3 from the charity stripe, and no fouls yet. Sir Winston Churchill, very disciplined. But with that little contact, Bishop McNally has been able to jump out to a 24-17 lead and get all those points in the paint. Cricostomo, guarded by Cole. Baltazar gets stopped. Lacombe puts it behind his back, now dribbles, he's in trouble in the corner. Gets it to Baltazar. Also into the game now, Deshaun Porter. Henry has to get it up in time and does, but it's a missed shot and a rebound for Kyle Gill. Here comes Valdez. Looks to attack Cricostomo. Goes into the body with the right, yes!
Darian Valdez has certainly stood out among the crowd here and is getting a good response from his Sir Winston Churchill fans and teammates and classmates.
There's the look at Mike Fullerton and Morgan Tudor, the coaches for the Bulldogs. Division I championship between these two teams. Emory Gill will try to come in for a quick trap. And there you see a different defensive strategy, this trapping pressure. And it ends up in a rebound for Henry, who goes up with it and misses the easy layup. Gets his own rebound, it goes out of bounds. So a break for Churchill, close proximity shot for Henry, who's been great tonight so far with 8 points.
Yeah, he's looked fantastic to this point for sure.
One shot, 6 seconds left. Gil, Valdez in trouble. Ekomi gets it, 2 seconds left. They'll have to get a shot off, and nope, that will not count before the buzzer, but a 24-19 lead for the Wolves as the first quarter ends in an electric Jack Simpson Gymnasium. We'll be back with only 11 shots taken by the Bulldogs, 24. So the Bishop McNally team has hit as many shots as Churchill has taken as a team. There's number 12, but it's off the mark for Valdez.
Yeah, Churchill takes their time while McNally, if they can fast break, they will. And they try almost every time.
Grumbo drives to the baseline, shot with the left, no good. Rebound, Cobb had it momentarily. Common job back into the game after that 8 point first quarter, sat the last few minutes, and now a definite size advantage with Jopp being guarded by Porter. We'll see if they try to get him the ball. Here's Fullerton, gets into the lane once again. Grumbo all over him. Valdez gets in the paint with the right and scores. Big bucket for Darian Valdez. That cuts the lead to 3 for Bishop McNally.
It's the Fullerton and Valdez show right now for Churchill and White, but if they want things to continue in a successful way, they're going to have to distribute the ball a lot more to their teammates, because right now McNally, it's everyone in the gym basically knows what's going to be happening for from Churchill's offensive strategy.
Also kind of surprising as Henry drives and scores is that they're trying to roll Fullerton with whoever his forward is instead of just maybe get a look to Vlad or Cobb and just give them a quick iso, give them an opportunity with that size advantage. Well, here's Zasmolin quickly to Chop. Nice move, nice footwork, and scores. What do I know? 10 points for Chop. Porter drives. Looks like there might have been a Churchill block. And the Bulldogs looking to cut this three-point deficit. Fullerton, awkward one-footed leader a la Dirk Nowitzki, and can't get it to drop.
The trouble with Fullerton is he's the point guard and the quarterback, but he's the smallest guy on the floor, so anyone can just show up and cover him. And if they cover him well enough, he can't find an outlet. I mean, he reminds me of Nash, like, from the first possession of the game. But as I said, he's got to have a better vision than
Here's
that.
Here's the steal by Ekomi, who will go up and throw it down with a soft touch. And just like that, the Wolves lead back up to 7 after Winston Churchill had gotten it down to 3. And you know what, Fullerton, he looks like he's right out of a 1950s TV show. Valdez looking inside for Jopp, but that pass at his feet, but he's able to recover. Nice job by Jopp. He wants it inside. Fullerton,
3 on the clock. That won't go.
Gets it off in time, off the rim. And it's a fresh 24 for Sir Winston Churchill. Valdez can't get the finish and will go the other way. Looks like it'll be a foul on the Bulldogs. Fever pitch here in the second. It'll be the first for Sir Winston Churchill on Jopp. Back into the game, making actually his first appearance, Kyle Gill. Chance of defense from the Bulldog side. Ekomi. Richard Rocha into the game as well for the Timberwolves. Ekomi, who had that little dunk before, drives in, wants two more, draws the foul.
See, there you go. Ekomi found himself open, got the signal over to Rocha and said, hey, give it to me, and look what the result is. I mean, honestly, what the advantage for McNally is that they're on the side that Churchill is attacking right now. They're as loud as they can be, and then you can't see your teammate, you can't hear your teammate. What are you supposed to do? So McNally's crowd making a huge difference.
Ekome hits both, 32-23, the lead up to 9. So this patient offense that Sir Winston Churchill likes to run right now, falling to the fast-paced Timberwolves attack. Good job by Henry to stay on Valdez. Cole gives it right back to Darian. Great defense that time by Clayton Henry all over Valdez, forcing him to step out of bounds, and a big turnover for the T-Wolves.
What do you guess that Cole and Valdez went to the same barber on the same day and said, give us two of these, please?
Henry is able to get Jop up in the air, nearly intercepted by Cole. Coaches Tyler Carl and James Wood shouting instructions to their team, also rocking the turquoise color. And now a little bit of quiet in the gym as Bishop McNally runs their offense. Rocha. And that off-balance shot by Dejon Vaughn doesn't go. Up ahead once again to John. Nice pump fake with the right, rolls off and draws the foul. That's going to go against Henry. That'll be his first.
Yeah, as the differential increases, the fans' voices seem to decrease.
We'll get another look at that foul. There's Jop. Might have gotten away with the travel there as well as Henry came over from behind. Hits the first. 11 points now for Jop, the high score for the Bulldogs. But right now, the T-Wolves offense has been able to get to the rack. 14 points in the paint. Many driving to the hole. And Henry will get a well-deserved break.
McNally with 5 of their 32 points on the floor right now.
Nice steal that time by Cole. Tries to bump off Quiambo, loses his balance. And that's going to be a foul on Quiambo. That's going to be his first, team second. And Fullerton will come back into the game.
Yeah, we haven't seen a lot of fouls so far in the opening game today. John Diefenbaker had 5 fouls in the first 3 minutes of the first quarter. They calmed down after that, but three different games, three different first quarters for sure, or first halves
cool.
Today.
Gets the pass from Fullerton, gives it right back to the point guard who takes a three and hits it. Big time three for little Matt Fullerton. His first field goal as well. And a turnover. The pass up ahead to William Walter, who's into the game now. And we have a timeout taken in their second last game of the regular season. They had won 8 straight up until that point. Oh, correction, they did have one other loss. That was to Crescent Heights. And that was just a 1-point game, a 72-71 Crescent Heights victory.
Yeah, Churchill has not lost since February 6th. And that's the only loss of the year.
That to St. Francis.
Well, in city games, of course, tournaments can be different.
Gill takes the jumper, no good. Inside, Jop, nearly a steal, and that's going to be a foul on Porter, team's third.
You can clearly tell that Fullerton is the man in charge. He will direct all the offense. Everything will flow through him. The other games we saw with the other four teams, it was basically improvisation more than anything else.
It was a nice flash on that previous lay by Porter as Fullerton is trying to get away from his defender. And now this small lineup for Bishop McNally as Ekome launches a deep three, and what a rebound for Vashawn Parter, and he gets held up. Possession now of Bishop McNally. Man, you look at this lineup on the floor right now. William Walter, well below 6 feet, is only a little bit taller than Matt Fullerton. Walter is trying to box out Vlad Zasmalin.
Yeah, sometimes the matchups just don't really work as well as you'd like them to, but that's what you got to figure out between each whistle. I've got him, you've got him, and figure it out.
And Bishop McNally trying to use her speed. It's worked so far. They're up four, trying to make it six. Wesicomi, but he misses. Cole with the rebound.
And with offense, you can exploit mismatches. That's why basketball games are 90-90 and not 10-10, like hockey games, which are 1-1.
Cole. Jump, trying to get away from Henry, and does, but he can't get the finish. Nice board by Clayton Henry, having himself quite a game. The speed, the drive, and a foul.
I think Bishop McNally would be very happy to just shoot free throws all night long if that's what it takes to draw from those.
Well, we're going to take a break now, and then we will come back with more. We see that replay and the foul on Jopp. That's also his second, so we'll have to keep an eye on that. We'll be back with more on portal.stretchinternet.com/Maverick Media. .427 left to go here in the first half, and what has been a very tight, entertaining basketball game. The Wolves lead 32-28 in the Division I Championship of Calgary.
Yeah, and everything's on the line this week. Both teams will be in Edmonton, Jasper Place High School, next Thursday, Friday, Saturday for some great provincial action. And if they see each other again, I wouldn't be surprised.
Clayton Henry now at the line, and he has 11 points. The co-captain of this team, no fear whatsoever in his game, along with Yacomi, and hits the second. Here comes Sir Winston Churchill. Matt Colotin might look to attack. Costa Moen does, looking inside for Graywall, but it goes out to Gill. Amrit Gill off the bench. Inside. Now there's a post-up opportunity for Zizem. A beautiful move and draws the foul. Beautiful footwork by Vladdy in the post, and he'll go to the line.
Now this is an opportunity for Fullerton to distribute the ball to players that currently don't have baskets, excluding Wesley Cole, of course, who has five. So a chance to get three more of these guys in, including Vlad Zasmalin, if he can make this second free throw.
Misses the first, and we have a whistle. And this is a little bit of a concern. Matt Fullerton, looks like he might have taken a shot, is holding his nose or face. So now the training staff will have a look at him and make sure they can hopefully stop the bleeding. That would be a big loss, and Vlad hits the second.
Now it's Kyle Gill's chance to lead these Bulldogs.
Costimo, a little bit quiet in this quarter after opening it up with eight in the first. So much for that. And one. I'll take the change and go to the line. 7-point lead as Costimo go to the line. There you see the drive gets right by Gill and scores. Walter will come out of the match.
And that replay is a perfect example of why you use the square on the backboard instead of just trying to overhook it over the near side of the rim, because the odds are much better in your favor in terms of the basket going in and the rebounding opportunity.
And after the missed free throw, another opportunity for Bishop McNally, who continued to fight and claw despite being very much undersized. Yacomi drives, draws the foul, and one! Ivan Yacomi. Give him 9 points, and it's a 38-29 lead. We're going to see Fullerton, who's back in. So a short rest for Fullerton, their point guard. There's Akomi, and cannot complete the three-point play. And it looks like it's going to be a foul on Bishop McNally. Looks like it's on Jairus DeJesus, number 22. And now both teams in the penalty, Dave, as we'll see.
Yeah,
Valdez go to the line.
We're seeing a lot more drives, which means a lot more fouls, a lot more hacks, and a lot more free throws. We're going to be here for a while. 3:45 still left in the second quarter.
Valdez hits the first. He has seven. So there we see Coral giving out instructions as Valdez hits both. Henry putting on the move, step back, he'll try to attack once again. Nice defense that time by Graywall to stay with the quick click. DeJesus goes to the spin, goes to the left, and gets his own rebound. Unbelievable rebounding ferocity. Here comes Damian Valdez, and a steal by Deshaun Vaughn.
Valdez is going to be a key. They gave up a lot of points when he was on the bench, and he'll try to even it up here with 3 minutes to go, with a nice steal.
Cocosimo, a block by Valdez, and another steal by Bishop McNally. Those pesky guards will not go away. Henry gets in the paint and has it blocked. Graywall takes it down, and that's going to be a foul on Henry, and for Henry, that's his second.
And big props to the crew. You literally, in your ear, if you were listening the way we were, heard the hand go onto the backboard because of the video and audio quality that has been produced here by Maverick Media. Unbelievable quality, and I just got to thank everybody for the maximum effort. We're having a great time here up in the booth.
Graywall will go to the line. And now for Bishop McNally with 2:55 remaining and two fouls on Henry. Do you take him out now? You don't want him to pick up that third. It's a six-point game. Graywall misses the second. Rebound for Valdez, but he can't finish. And Henry comes away with it. The legs are flailing for Clayton. Cricostomo now at the top. Guambo gets in. Nice left-handed layup. Henry can't get the finish, but once again, it goes to a Timberwolf from the corner. Or near the corner, the three-point attempt by Quiambo is off.
We're definitely seeing two
Fullerton
different
strategies. Right back to Cole, but he can't handle the ball. They'll say last touch by the Timberwolves, who disagree, but it will be Bulldog possession.
Yeah, if you accumulate the entire first half, we're seeing two different strategies here where the Bulldogs are running down the 24-second clock about 80% of the time, and the Wolves are running down the shot clock about 20% of the time. If we look at the first quarter stats, you talked about it, how McNally had made more than Churchill had shot, but the field goal percentage, McNally's 46, Churchill's 64. However, they want that efficiency to continue. Unfortunately, the 22 minutes is going to disappear on them quicker than they think.
Henry, guarded by Jock, looking for DeJesus inside, wrapped up, and someone lost a headband, it appears, on the floor. Or a leg brace, or a leg band, excuse me. That was of Zasmalin. So after the wrap-up, it'll be Churchill ball. So a critical 2 minutes and 5 seconds for Churchill, trying to make this a one-possession game, or possibly take the lead if they can dominate these last 2 minutes. Great anticipation by DeJesus. It's a 4-on-1. Henry up ahead to Cricostomo, who does not finish. Rebound jump. Up ahead, Vlad is wide open. Valdez brings it down. Might have gotten away with a traveling violation. He'll take a long three. Perhaps ill-advised with so much time on the shot clock. Nice move by Cricostomo behind his back. Nice ball movement by McNally. Traveling violation. Good call. Hopped on that shot.
Yeah, McNally couldn't take advantage of the 4-on-1, but they were provided it simply because Fullerton approached that play offensively in a 1-on-4 position. McNally surrounded him, as they have all game long, and took it away.
Fullerton at the top now. Here's Cole looking inside for Chop, and another traveling violation.
As you can see,
and now a little bit of trash talking between Cricostomo and Cole. I love it.
As you can see in the red paint, Coben Job is 3 inches taller than anybody in a turquoise jersey. They've got to feed it inside to him. A referee's a good buddy of mine, and he is going to take any flack from any players or any coaches or any fans.
To Costimo, 10 points. Henry also in double figures with 12, the same as the number on his jersey. To Costimo gives it back to Vaughn. Henry with a deep three from the top, and he looks to the crowd and says, stay for the whole party. There's drinks in the back. Valdez drives, going behind his back to chop. Nice move off the glass. Short rebound. Zasmalin and a big one. Make it a 7-point game.
Churchill really needs a stop here. They want it to be 5 instead of 9 going into the break.
And we're going to have a foul. 14. We'll see who it's again. It's on Zasmalin. So that'll be his first, and it'll send DeJesus to the line. 40 seconds remaining in the opening half. Bishop McNally and Sir Winston Churchill. DeJesus misses the first. Critical possession coming up for the Bulldogs.
I was going to say, with a couple minutes to go, I think Churchill's coaches would have been ecstatic if the game had gone into halftime with a tie, but McNally's just kept the pressure on.
And DeJesus gets the friendly roll. So Jopp will come out with his team down 8. And we'll see what play the Bulldogs get here. Actually, no, Jopp is going to stay on the floor.
I think the refs allowed McNally to change, but not Churchill to change. That was a little strange.
And into the game for Churchill. Ogawa up ahead. Kyombo rolls off the rim. Here comes Graywall. Gives it to Fullerton. Wide open up top. And that's off. Graywall storms in, and it's off of the Timberwolf. 17 seconds remaining. Final shot opportunity for Sir Winston Churchill.
Get the ball.
Ogawa. So a smaller lineup now for Churchill. Maybe look to get it to Valdez. He's in the corner. Deep three. Misses. And an easy tip back that time by Zasmalin. He's been on the glass a little bit with 5 points.
Zasmalin is a guy who can make or break this game in the second half. If he wants to, and if they feed it to him, he has that kind of size and ability and that tenacity, as you just saw a moment ago. But right now, I think this game is going to go as Valdez and Fullerton decide. If they clean up their act in the second half, Churchill will be fine. If they continue to get dominated, this game may have already been decided.
Cricostomo hits the first and misses the second, and that's going to do it. So the Bishop McNally Timberwolves turn on the gas and don't take their foot off the pedal. They lead 43-36 at halftime.
12 or less, half or less, and get the shot that they want. McNally is just run, and they are fine with that. 130, fine with us.
11-13 from the free throw line for the Bulldogs, kind of keeping them into the game, but 19 turnovers in that first half. The reversal by Zasmalin doesn't go, but immediately a very quick shot. A little bit different than what we saw in the first half. And that foul is going to be on Ekobi, and that's a big one. That's his third. So now he'll have to come out right away, the co-captain of this Timberwolves team, as Deshaun Vaughn will come into the game. There's Vlad Zasmalin. Zasmalin, who had one of two free throws in the first half and is now 2 for 3.
Yeah, first good play call by Sir Winston Churchill, the guy you want in the position you want, and they do get paid off for it, halfway at least.
Vaughn, beautiful dish inside. Nice look for Jairus DeJesus, and it's an 8-point game.
Seems like McNally will hold the ball only if they have to, only if the opening wasn't already there.
Chop wants it inside and gets it. Immediately goes to the rack and scores. So obviously, I think they listened to our analysis.
Oh, please, I hope they did.
Dave, and they were able to immediately go into Zasmalin, as well as Jop, and it results in some good opportunities for them. And now we have a foul that's going to go against Cole, so he'll come out of the game. Igawa will come back in. So the regular starting five for the Bulldogs on the floor.
Yeah, and you didn't really notice Fullerton in either one of those possessions, so maybe they did make some changes in the second half. I mean, Fullerton's not going to say, give me the ball less, coach, but maybe some strategy did get figured out.
Good defense by Zasmalin creating the steal. And he gives it to Valdez with 8 points so far tonight. Jop, he'll take a jumper. And it rolls home. Robin Jop.
Very well down. They found the opening and took advantage of it.
There's Clayton Henry. 15 big first half points to lead his team. Ricostomo, a nice drive. He can't finish. Fullerton wide open up ahead. And he gets the easy finger roll, and just like that, it's a 2-point game.
And that was the key in the last 30 to 60 seconds. If you let it go to 9 or 10 or 11, you're in trouble, but 7 is a reasonable deficit, especially with the first possession of the half. You can make a plan, and so far, Churchill is pretty much perfect with that plan.
Zasmalin, and there you see the coaching staff speaking it over with Cole. Zasmalin with a strong rebound. That's another area where Churchill was good in the first half, 26-17. Clayton Henry, 10 rebounds in that first half, so he's got a double-double.
The Bulldogs are here because they know what they do best, and then they do it.
Jop wasn't initially ready for that pass. Zasmalin goes in for the board on the offensive glass and gets it out. Another shot attempt by Igawa, and he misses again. Two straight misses for Igawa.
That would have been a huge bucket. That would have put them in the lead for the first time since at least the quarter mark.
Ricostomo Henry sizes up. Quick pass. It'll be a big jumper by Vishon Porter. And those are his first 2 points of the game. The lead back up to two possessions. Chop gets it at the free throw line. He'll take a jumper, nails it.
Nice switch between Zasmalin and Jop. The defenseman got mixed up, and Jop was able to put that one in.
Vaughn, guarded by the much taller Valdez. Here's Porter, who just hit that jumper, will go in on Zasmalin, and it rolls home. So good job by Vishon Porter to come off the bench and hit some critical buckets here in the third quarter. Zasmalin wants it, gets it, in the post, guarded by Vaughn, beautiful spin, and the Churchill offense is pretty simple as Jop points to Zasmalin, says yes, keep doing it, but they can't get back in time as Henry draws the foul. And even when scored on, it's still a fast break opportunity for Bishop McNally.
Except for those missed threes, Churchill's offense has pretty much been executed perfectly. Another thing you can't help but notice in these 3 minutes, Valdez has been invisible, which I think is the coach's plan. you want to tell your opponents, we've got more than two guys to think about, coach.
Job now will come off of the floor after picking up his third foul. That's a big one, obviously, their leading scorer. Henry hits the first. 16 points now for Clayton Henry, having a monster game. He has two fouls as well. Misses the second. No, actually it rolls home. Spoke too soon. Fullerton will bring it up the floor.
These are some interesting rims here at the Jack Simpson gym. There's been some interesting rolls and bounces you never see in any other gym in this city.
Speaking of the Jack, of course, the home of the Dinos. A number of the Dinos here for this game and local Calgarians. Emmett Cook is here. LJ Hegland is here. Donis Montfort Palomino is here.
Maybe Gray checking Wall. On some future teammates.
Exactly.
Here.
Valdez looking inside for Graywall. He'll screen out. Nice defense by Henry on Valdez. Still with the ball. Zasmalin. Huge block by Clayton Henry in a dangerous collision. Graywall gets right back up after falling. Precostimo won't wait for anybody. Henry inside the left hand. Nice adjustment. But that's going to be over the back on Porter with his team up four. And right now, Tyler Coral telling his team to just calm down just a little bit. You want to be fast but not out of control, as Fullerton will bring the ball up.
Yeah, this game is not first to 100 wins. But, I mean, they're excited. They're full of adrenaline. You couldn't help but be in front of a crowd like this.
And that foul is going to send Zasmalin to the line.
You have to think that the Roughnecks game at the Saddle Dome is the only higher attended event of any kind in Calgary tonight besides this game.
Shooting two will be Vlad Zasmalin, who's had himself a nice quarter here. Takes the free throw and hits it. Vlad Zasmalin, wearing number 13 at forward for the Bulldogs. And misses the second. It's a three-point game. Krikostomo is able to get away from Zasmalin. Here comes the speedy guard. The finger roll is good.
Terrence Krikostomo lays it in.
Valdez looks to attack the defense himself and does, and scores. So right back the other way. Valdez now with 10. He's in double figures. Terrence will try to attack. Cole goes to the crossover, gets the finger roll, and Zasmalin can only foul him in the air.
Beautifully done there as the foul count 5-2 now becomes 5-3, and we're going to be seeing a lot of free throws here in the next few minutes.
Zasmalin kind of crunched down, and looks like we are going to get a couple substitutions, so we'll see Porter come back into the game along with Jamin Pelly. Pelly with those two fouls. Porter as well.
Yeah, Pelly's got to be careful. The right kind of bumping versus the wrong kind of bumping. And that's what we saw from him in the first quarter.
Terrence Krikostomo, 14 points. And we're going to get a timeout. Bulldogs and the Bishop McNally Timberwolves.
Never seen a bulldog dance like that before.
Yes, that is a very unique animal. Fullerton. Emery Gill into the game. Looking inside. Here's Vladdy outside. Cole with the three. That's short. And a rebound by Solomon Odele, making his first appearance in the game, and he has it up top. Krikostomo looks to attack and does once again get to the rack and finishes. More beautiful, dynamic shot making by Terrence Krikostomo. But you know what? He loves to go to his right, and that's something that Churchill might look to try to alter defensively. Zasmalin will give a screen to Valdez. Gets it right back. Here's Vlad. Looks to attack Jamin Pelly into his body, and it goes down.
Another interesting bounce off these Jack Simpson rims.
They're shooter's rims, that's for sure. Krikostomo once again goes right, met in the air.
I think these rims are either really, really new or really, really old. I can't tell yet.
Well, they're maintained phenomenally here at the Jack. Odele. Nearly stepping out of bounds with Porter. Here's Odelay guarded by Fullerton. Vaughn gets some space. Taken down by Gill. And immediately the quarterback pass to Fullerton. And the receiver finishes in the end zone.
Vaughn had Cole completely turned around, but just couldn't find the pass.
Amazing vision by Gill. Cricostomo down the lane and draws another foul. And I don't know why Churchill is getting so close to Cricostomo. You know that he wants to drive. Back off and see if he'll take a shot. We'll get another look at it. See, the way that Cole is just way too close to Cricostomo, he's going to blow by you every single time. And hits the free throw.
And that's a good effort on a one-on-four play. He's able to draw the foul and get at least halfway paid off. I mean, most any higher level, you don't even go for a shot like that because it's going to get knocked away. But he gets the maximum scoring that he could have.
Here's Fullerton, 7 points after that layup. His team's still down four. So Winston Churchill has picked up the pace a little bit. And a steal by Vaughn. Trying to get past Gill. Nice movement by Amory. That pass a little bit too far out, and he goes out of bounds. And we're going to have Comey come back into the game. Igawa and Graywall. Well, Igawa's going to stay, actually. Graywall's going to come in for Gill. And Fullerton will run the show with 4:02 left to go here in the third. Here's Cole, the southpaw, wants Graywall. And has him in the post against Jamin Pelly. Good matchup there. Fullerton backs up, goes to the crossover. And is that going to be a foul? It will be. It looks like that's going to go against Odelay, and Fullerton will go to the line.
I love his efforts, Fullerton. I love his intensity. He's just too small. And unfortunately, basketball is the game of the people that were born the tallest. But he's treating it like a Steve Nash, like a Muggsy Bogues. He's going to do whatever he can to contribute. And he drew that foul. He did the maximum he could because there was no way he was going to get over them to get that ball in the air high enough to go into the basket. So he's doing what he can, and I applaud his efforts.
Fullerton hits the second after missing the first, and he has 8 points. Cricostomo, once again, being guarded by Cole. Strong drive by Akomi, can't finish. Henry there. Instead, it'll be Jamin Pelly, and we have a whistle. It's going to be 2 shots. So the Wolves have been able to withstand Bulldogs going inside. Here's Jamin Pelly. And misses the first. Jamin Pelly wearing number 33. 2 points for him tonight.
He's got a fan in the crowd. The back of her shirt says 33 on it.
And hits the second. Here comes Fullerton. Nice move, the setter step. And they'll say he carried it. And it'll go back to Bishop McNally.
McNally got here by beating Fava Lacombe 77-66 in the quarterfinals and then beating Ernest Manning 81-72 in the semis. This team won the junior championship 2 years ago, so they're used to this pressure and being together as a team for the last 3 years.
Another whistle on Churchill, so that'll be more free throws. It'll be Henry who will go to the line. As for Sir Winston Churchill, they defeated William Aberhart 92-57, and then Bishop O'Byrne 104-75, so routes on their way to the championship, but they're down right now by four.
They haven't led since early in the first quarter. The second quarter, the difference basically went from 5-9 to 5-9. Here it's gone from 2-6 to 2-6, so they are making progress.
This is the second rebound. Goes to Zasmo. Fullerton. The Bulldogs down five. Nice move to get around Odelay, but he can't get the finish. Cricostomo, beautiful dish to Henry. I see you running. And I'll give you the rock. It's back up to 62. 55, a 7-point lead. There's Valdez driving right to the rack. And he's got 12.
Great effort by Valdez. He hasn't gotten too high, hasn't gotten too low. He just goes in, gets the ball, drives, and tries to get a score.
Ekome, a deep three, misses. Rebound, Cole. And he's got some court to work with. Outside Valdez, and great hustle that time by Odele, getting back on defense and is able to knock it out of bounds and prevent a possible shot for the Bulldogs. Graywall, Fullerton, Odele right in his face. Valdez, the catch, the shoot, and the miss. Odele gets sent down as Asmalin, and Fullerton thought that Valdez was going to be cutting to the bucket, but he didn't, and it's a turnover. This is very critical here. Sorry, Dave.
No,
just
no,
very
no.
critical here for Winston Churchill not to get too panicked if they make a bad play like they just did. So critical. There's plenty of time left. You got a whole other quarter and 2:12 remaining in the third.
Yeah, and actually I was going to say something very, very similar to that. They don't seem to have a plan once they give up a turnover to either be able to sprint back, because McNally either has the speed or they're not prepared to have a fifth man back just in case. They're not prepared for anything that isn't the best case scenario. So that's why McNally's been able to take advantage of these type of situations more often than not.
Grucostomo now with 20 points. Henry also with 20. Ekome with 11. So the big three for Bishop McNally doing what they were supposed to do, talking with the coaching staff beforehand. They said it was going to be Terrence Ivan and Clayton to lead us, and that's exactly what they've done. Here's Fullerton. 2:05 remaining. Zasmalin will give a screen to Fullerton, who backs up, takes a three, and it rolls out. That would have made it a 4-point game.
That could be a huge miss here, especially if McNally can take advantage of it.
They leave Ekome wide open, and he makes them pay. Big time three from Ivan Ekome. Graywall, direction, that's Gill, who misses the shot, and a rebound by Zasmalin. Fullerton gives it right back. It'll be Gill again, and misses another long shot. Here come the Timberwolves in transition. And again, the Bulldogs putting a lot of pressure on the Timberwolves guards, and that's playing right into what they want to do. There goes Grucostomo once again. Grucostomo with a big layup, and taking a shot in the face was Valdez. Valdez taking a tough shot. We'll see if he comes off of the floor. Grucostomo now pushes the Timberwolves lead to 69-57, and Valdez says he's okay. Grucostomo will try to complete the 3-point play. Misses. And the rebound goes to who else? Clayton Henry. Ekome will try again and hits back to back from 3-point land. 72-57. Bishop McNally breaking down the door in the later part of this third quarter. A double team on Fullerton. Valdez in the corner, and he stepped out of bounds.
I'll stress once again how big of a miss that, not to pick on Fullerton, but just how big of a miss that three was, because that was a 7-point difference that becomes a four if he makes that shot, and now seven has become 15 in the blink of an eye.
Nice move that time by Odele, and the crowd loves it. That's his first bucket of the night. Fullerton. Quick pass to Igawa. They need this shot and they don't get it. And they'll hold for a final one. Ekome will bring the ball up the floor. 16 points on the night for Ivan. Jamin Pelly in the post. Beautiful move by Zasmalin, and he finishes. And that's the way it's been for the Bishop McNally Timberwolves. They have blown this game open, up 19 points.
That's got to be an 11-0 or
As we head into the fourth, Coben Jopp still leads the Churchill Bulldogs with 18 points. For Bishop McNally, it is Terrence Chrysostomo with 22 points.
So the Timberwolves blowing the door open in that third quarter, outscoring the Bulldogs 33-21, and Henry wants more, but it goes off his foot and out of bounds.
Very key play there for Sir Winston Churchill. They have two timeouts remaining. What was said in that 60-second period? I would have loved to have had a little mini microphone in there to find out, because they've got to completely reset themselves. Like I said, it had to have been a 12-0 run in those last 2 minutes. The game was completely flipped on its head. They're anticipating what Fullerton wants to do right now. He can't drive and he can't pass.
There's a foul. It's going to go against Quambo. Vaughn will come in. Quambo will come off the floor and go to the bench.
And the McNally fans just get louder and louder. This is a huge development for their program. I've been to their gym several times, and there's all these Division II, Division III banners.
What would it be for a Division I, exactly?
Yeah, exactly. And it's an interesting system here. It's not population like football. It's not promotion relegation like European soccer leagues. It's a different style, and for them to go from 3-1 is just fantastic.
And that time, perhaps a little bit too unselfish, Jamin Pelly giving it up to Deshaun Vaughn, had a wide open look at the basket, and I think that's what Coach Carl was telling his team, shoot the ball.
Yeah, both teams will be at Provincials next weekend in Edmonton. Both teams will learn from this game for sure. I expect Churchill to do very well next weekend, and should be very interesting. At least four, if not five, Calgary teams will be there.
Coben Jopp takes the shot, and he misses. Here's a big stop for the Timberwolves. Already a minute gone by in the fourth quarter. Churchill has to be perfect. Jopp with the rejection, takes the ball, and will look for his point guard. Instead, he'll just pull back and give it to Valdez. Zasmalin sees a cutting Jopp, beats him down the floor. And he throws it into the hands, and here comes a wide open. Here comes Henry, draws the foul, and he'll go to the line. Looked like he might have wanted to try to bring the roof down with the dunk. But what else can you say about Clayton Henry? 20 points, 14 rebounds, one block, and an assist. As we get another look at it, there you see him in the open floor and the hack.
And at that point, any defensive player you see from 8-year-olds to 38-year-olds in the NBA, that's just like, whatever I can do to make sure that the automatic basket doesn't go in. And he's going to try to get a 2-for-2 here on the free throw line.
The lead now pushed to 20. A reminder, ladies and gentlemen, we will be speaking to a member of the winning team, perhaps a coach as well, so please stay tuned for the trophy presentations. You're going to want to watch that. Igawa gets the step and gets the bucket, and that will count. A big bucket finally for the Bulldogs. Their first bucket coming at 8:23 of the fourth quarter.
Shooting for one is number eight.
Get another look at it. There's Igawa on the drive. And hits. Completes the three-point play. It's an 18-point game. But right now, they need stops to the Bulldogs, and they're going to try to put a little bit more pressure near half court. Going to try to trap the McNally Timberwolves. There's Ikomi misses the three, and a rebound, Pelly! And Ikomi tracks it down, a fresh 24, and Coral says, let's just hold it. We've got the time. Henry, the turnaround jumper, no, rebounds, Asmalin.
Churchill fans have got to get loud. They've got to make sure McNally can't hear each other.
Fullerton will take the jumper. That's a three. Miss. And rebound, an easy one for Rocha.
I'm convinced that all three games, all six teams, they thought that the three-point line was the red, and that, or was the black line, and that the 3 points for the girls only. But it's actually a three for everybody here in the high school level.
Everybody getting in on the action. Richard Rocha now with his third and fourth point. And the Bulldogs have to hurry. They are down 20. Igawa once again gets the set, draws the foul on Pelly. So Nico Igawa, a senior, trying to do everything that he can to get the Bulldogs back in this game. Jamin Pelly will come out. That's his third. Get another look at that drive. He's going to go right into the body of Pelly. A clear foul. And I'm not sure if that actually counted. I think he might have just thrown it up there. We'll take a break and we'll be back with more on portal.stretchinternet.com/Maverick Media, courtesy of the Big Give Project.
Pump up your school, guys. Let's get loud. It's the fourth. And now, if you are a Wolves fan, it's time to get loud. All Wolves fans in the house, make some noise!
So at the line now, Igawa will take the first free throw and hits it. Still plenty of time in this game, but Winston Churchill just has to get stop after stop after stop. And right now at the lineup on the floor, Chrysostomo rather, getting a break. Henry though is still out there, and Igawa hits both. And we'll see if the Bulldogs will once again go to the trap. Back almost into his zone, if you will. Henry drives to the rack, can't finish. Here comes Cole. Splits the double team. Splits it again and draws a foul. That's going to be the fourth foul on the Timberwolves. So one more and they'll be in the penalty.
Yeah, right now Churchill has to out McNally at this point. They have to change the strategy a little bit. They've got to create things within 7, 8, 9 seconds on the shot clock. They know that they don't have time to take the shots that they would have taken in the first quarter, so we'll see what happens.
Chrysostomo now back into the game along with Quiombo. Nearly a steal by Henry, and he gets one. He'll try to go to the rack again, and he does. Clayton Henry. He wants to be the MVP, and he's playing like it with 24. The double-double. Henry all over Cole right now. Graywall wants it in the post and gets it. One dribble, two dribble drive. And that's going to be a traveling violation.
That's the thing when you run into a wall and you try to spin out of it, it usually means a 2.5 or a third step.
And coming into the game now for Sir Winston Churchill, Jesse Tam, number two. Also into the game for the first time, Sam Kerber, so we'll have to see if Fullerton just wants some fresh legs or if he might be conceding defeat with some of the players who are on the floor. I don't expect that. Here's the Jesus with a nice drive and finish. Make it a 22-point lead, and now an interception. Here comes Vaughn going right in to Graywall, but a block. Here comes Graywall by himself in the corner. A wide open look for Kerber right off the bench. Sam Kerber, welcome to the party, and he hits a three.
And the Bulldogs fans right behind them again. They've got it. They've got to stay loud.
There's a turnover. Here comes Cole, puts it behind his back, and that's going to be a foul on Chrysostomo. That'll be his third, and it'll send Cole to the line. Jopp and Valdez will come back in. And right now they need a tidal wave of offense and a wall of defense to get back in the game, and we'll take another timeout. And we'll be back with more right coming up.
Let's get loud, fans. Under 6 minutes left in this championship game.
So we'll get another look at that last play. There you see Chrysostomo get in, trying to go for that pickpocket on Cole, but it's a foul, so Wesley Cole will step to the line. Some big free throws here, as we mentioned. This game not completely over, as we see Chuck come back into the game. Valdez as well. And they're going to continue with that trap defense, the Bulldogs. And he hits both. 17-point game. Chrysostomo quickly gets it to Thrombo. DeJesus sees the double team. Thrombo back to DeJesus. Chrysostomo takes a three. I don't know if he's taken a three all game. He has not. That's his first attempt from downtown. Tam wanted the call, doesn't get it. And it'll be Churchill ball. So after a break, Henry comes back out onto the floor along with Nakomi and Pelly.
It's funny to me to watch these high school kids dance to a song that didn't even, that was out before any of them were even born. It's like me dancing to Elvis.
Great music lives on no matter what the generation. And Chop knocks it down, give him 20 points, and it's a 15-point game. Pelly, here comes another double team. Henry quickly out to Nakomi from the corner. Misses, and that's out of bounds by Henry.
See, if he'd shot from the red line, that would have gone in.
So Fullerton will come back in. So credit this even third unit of Sir Winston Churchill. Kerber has given him some good minutes, as is Tam, to give the starters a break. And Churchill, if they can make a bucket here and get the 70-point plateau. Cole drives up with the left and one. Wesley Cole trying to throw some cold water on the Timberwolves. And it's 84-71. It could be a 12-point game. They led by as much as 22, I think, was their largest lead. Cole trying to complete the three-point play. Misses, but a rebound by Berker. Kerber with the drive, with the left, no! And it's taken back by Nakomi. And that would have been a huge bucket. Wide open, Henry underneath. Can't get it past Kopp, gets his own rebound, blocked by Jock. And now a traveling violation called on Pelly.
Bulldogs fans have come back to life here. They're going to support their teammates and their classmates and all the way to the end, no matter what.
And they are in the penalty, although that foul, a turnover, excuse me. So 84-71, here's Fullerton, looks to attack Biombo, who stays right with him. The turnaround shot, no. Not sure that's the one that his dad wanted. Of course, watching his son, the floor general, Matt Fullerton. Chrysostomo. Biombo, back to Terrence. Looking inside for Nakomi, and saved by Jupp. Great job by Common. Here comes Cole. Stop and pop with the left hand. No, rebound Valdez. I think he might have tried to get a pass inside to Kerber, but it was knocked away by Bishop McNally. Less than 4 minutes remaining, and this offense of Bishop McNally has gone cold a little bit. There's a quick double team, and a foul called on Cole. That's only the second against the Bulldogs.
Cole was trying to get the jump because it's to their advantage, but unfortunately his hand came off the ball and onto the men.
That's off the foot of Cole. 14 seconds on the shot clock. It's a 13-point lead for the Wolves as they try to win a Division I championship. Chrysostomo. Nakomi right back to Terrence. Gets past Cole, can't finish. Pelly with the rebound. Blocked, but a foul. And for Job, that's going to be his fourth.
Yeah, he definitely has a role here, does Jamin Pelly. He has a certain set of skills that no one else has. He has a certain body type that no one else has, and he's been able to take advantage of it despite the three fouls. He knows how to use it correctly, both offensively and defensively.
Misses the first free throw, so still some life for the Bulldogs. Njapp will have to be careful with 20 points, their leading scorer with four. Misses both and gets the big board.
Rebounding has been their strength throughout the contest, especially in the fourth quarter.
Fullerton tries to get into the paint, outside. And that three-point shot by Kerber is way short, and they needed it. Back into the game, Zasmalin.
I hate to keep mentioning it, but that he shoots that from the red line, and it goes in. Man, oh man. It's the red line, guys, not the black. Black will be next year when you're playing here for the Dinos or for the Cougars.
Fullerton, nice defense that time by Quambo. Gets it out to Cole. Nice drive, takes some contact, and it'll go to the line, and that's Pelly's fourth.
He's had a question for the referees after almost every call. He actually looked up to the big board to see if we were going to provide a replay. He wasn't sure that was a foul either.
Cole hits the second. And it's an 11-point game, and he has 11 points now. Some half-court pressure. Here's Clayton Henry, puts it between his legs, trying to put the move on Zasmalin. Ekomi just knocks Fullerton away, and that's an offensive foul. And that's going to be Ekomi's fourth. So a co-captain with four, Chrysostomo with four, and Pelly with four. We'll get another look at it. There you see Fullerton getting some good body position. Good job by Fullerton to just sacrifice his body. Valdez tries to attack. Gets to the free throw line, loses the ball, recovers it. Drop. The wide open shot rolls home. And it's a 9-point game. They get it within single digits, 2:32 remaining.
Three Timberwolves got caught looking at the ball there.
Pelly inside, it rolls home. Big shot for Jamin Pelly. And that time, Dave, knowing that Job didn't want to pick up that fifth foul, had to pull back a little bit.
Exactly, and that's a good call by the coach. Pelly with that linebackerish figure.
Job, the step back jumper, can't hit that one, and a big rebound for Clayton Henry. And now a foul, that's going to be two shots for Chrysostomo. Timeout taken. Folks, that last play, not a foul. It'll be just Timberwolves ball. Chrysostomo breaks the pressure. Ekomi, Henry's inside at the free throw line. Quiambo will take a three and hits it. Ice in the grill, gonna start a barbecue. That's a big shot for Quiambo, who has been quiet offensively. And coming right back is Fullerton.
Fullerton with the counter three there, yeah. I'll give you a three, but I'll take one back.
Henry inside, scores again.
Clayton Henry.
26 for Henry. And time running out for the Bulldogs. Fullerton gets in and draws a foul on Quiambo. That'll be his fourth.
Fullerton, the only player on the floor with less than three fouls. He has zero. Everyone else that you see has either three or four.
And now, if you are the Bulldogs, might have to think about fouling intentionally already with a minute and a half as Fullerton misses the first critical miss for the point guard. Minor, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be speaking to a member of the winning team and perhaps a coach as well. Misses the second. And a rebound by who else? Clayton Henry with some open court to work with. Goes into Fullerton, loses the ball, and then picks it up, gives it to Quiambo, and they'll just hold it up top. Chrysostomo says, let's slow down, and then he changes his mind. And that might be the dagger, unless we already didn't see the dagger, that three by Quiambo. Nice drive by Valdez, but he can't get the finish. Rebound, Pelly.
McNally's just going to let Churchill t- take as long as they want on offense just to kill the clock even more.
Ekome! And now it's time to celebrate with a minute remaining. There's another foul, and now the Wolves know that they're going to win the city championship. There's Jamin Pelly celebrating. Chrysostomo, the monster game, just continually attacking the rack as Jopp will take a free throw. Valiant effort for Jopp. Every player now for Sir Winston Churchill on the floor in double figures.
They don't really have a fan neutral zone like they do for football playoff games, but for the most part, the fans have behaved themselves, and it's just a little bit of friendly taunting across the floor.
Quambo. Henry, who did a little bit of everything for his team, is going to be exhausted by the end of it. Massive double-double. Quambo with another long three, no good. Fullerton will hurry, delaying the inevitable. Outside, Cole, cross-court pass, Valdez takes the three, that's short. Zasmalin brings it down. And time is running out. There's a whistle, looks like Zasmalin might have stepped on the ground, and now the party's gonna get started. It's gonna be sweet revenge for the Bishop McNally Timberwolves.
Too many men.
Jamin Pelly, I think, thought that there was a timeout.
Just a little excited there. There's going to be a lot more than 10 guys on the floor here in about 12 seconds. I can't wait to see how McNally does at provincials next week.
After
I've got tremendous potential to go a long way.
Well, after falling to Churchill in the regular season, they get sweet revenge. The title goes to the T-Wolves.
Tremendous effort by both teams. A lot of points put on the board as we expect.